Manny Pacquiao, Lucas Matthysse. I'm going to explain to you today what it is that took place last night between those two guys in that fight. And for those of you who do not see it, this will just be insight as to what you missed last night. But before I get started, I'd like to introduce myself. First of all, for those of you who have never watched this channel, shame on you. My name is Eric A. Bradley, AKA The Real Fight Doctor. And there is no other on this level. Now back to the topic at hand. Now let me explain what you guys witnessed last night. Speed, which equals to power, and the footwork was explosive. And when you got great footwork in boxing, let me explain this to you and break it down. It sets you up and allows you to land punches in a way that increases the power because of the angles in which you're punching on. So it takes a long time to teach a fighter how important it is to punch on an angle and stay off the line, which Manny Pacquiao did a great job with last night. I mean, when you saw him, the first thing I noticed when he touched Lucas Matthysse is Lucas could not really take the impact of the punches, even in the first round. So I knew at that point that the dexterity of his body wasn't enough to really overcome what Manny Pacquiao was gonna bring. But when you look at Manny Pacquiao and the spectacle of all of the fighters that are happening right now, all of the guys who are at the top of the sport, he actually looked as good as any welterweight. The guy that I know will give him mad problems, and he doesn't want problems with this guy, is Terrence Crawford, because of the angles and the way that he operates around the ring. Errol Spence walks forward. I see him beating Manny Pacquiao. The difference is he'll move. Manny Pacquiao will move, but Errol Spence will walk him down. Terrence Crawford will give him a lot of angles and switch hits, so that'll give Manny more problems. So those are the type of problems he doesn't want in his life at all. Now back to the topic. What you saw with Manny Pacquiao was the elusiveness. One thing that was very apparent when you saw him deliver the jab, and I'm in a conventional stance, but Manny Pacquiao is a southpaw. But when he delivered the jab, one thing that you notice about his jab is that he never stopped delivering it. And he continued to work behind it. Now is that Boo Boy? Because I never seen that consistency with his jab, even later on in the fight. Now it went seven, and even up till the seventh round, he was leading with the jab, then following up with combinations, whether twos, threes, or fours. It's hard to overcome that whenever you're in the ring and you are in there with someone who's explosive. He has the kind of speed, he has the kind of ring cachet, and he has the will to take you apart. He's never lost an ounce of that lion heart. And that's what you meet whenever you're in a fight and you've gotten mature and you're already a mogul, which he already is. You know, he's a Magic Johnson of boxing. He can go anywhere in this country and anywhere around the globe, and he's known and he's transient. So Manny Pacquiao, the fact that he has that type of cachet around the globe, he still fights like he'll fight to the last breath. I don't get that. You don't see that often. Floyd Mayweather did the same thing. He fought to the very end, until the very end. So you see that with Pacquiao, but let me break one last thing down, which is the method in which he was delivering the punches. Okay, so he was dropping that jab. Boom, 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 boom. Sometimes he followed it, boom, and came back off with the hook. Sometimes, boom, boom, bam, he came under with the uppercut. Let me explain what that does to a fighter that that's happening to. First, he's distracted by the jab. His head has to come back. He has to get refocused. By the time he gets refocused, boom, the uppercut is coming under, so he doesn't see it coming straight on. So that can offer up a flash knockdown, but when it has power behind it, it's a real knockdown. I mean, neurologically, boom, you're out of wits. Your legs are gone because the circulation's been cut off. That's one of the things that you witnessed last night. But Pacquiao's, he had that mustard on him. Boom, boom, So when he came up under, it was over. Once I saw him go down from that, I knew it was gonna be a very short night. And the fact that he continued to move around the ring, throwing his combination and sliding around, man, it takes a lot to teach a fighter how to do that. And him actually can develop that and carry it into the ring. So when I see Manny Pacquiao right now, what I see is an explosive guy who looks like he did 10 years ago. Or was maybe it the fact that Lucas Matthysse is an actual smaller guy and he's not beating up guys that's normally 20 pounds heavier than him. That could have a lot to do with the way he was able to perform and really beat the confidence out of Lucas Matthysse and his fighting ability, because he looked lost in there and just frustrated and taking knees. And that comes from the mental fortitude that Manny Pacquiao sucked out of him. That's what you call beating surrender into a fighter. That's kind of what it is once you get to a certain point in your life where you made your mind up that you're gonna train in training camp the way you used to, and that you're gonna deliver the kind of fight that the fans wanna see. In Macau, China, they're going crazy. Now, the next thing is who's next on that freaking calendar of Manny Pacquiao's? That's the question. So that's all I got for now. Leave your comments down below. Who do you think is going to be Manny Pacquiao's next? And will he perform like that? Or should he go back and get his face back against, you know, Jeff Horn over in Aussie? I don't know. What do you think? That's all I got for right now. My name is Eric A. Bradley, AKA The Real Fight Doctor, and this is Master Boxing. We break the fight world down, baby. Round by round. Shouts out to my man, George the Wild Prince Copa, who's now the IKF light middleweight champion. That's what it's all about. Go after your dreams, man. Over at Master Boxing, we make champions. Be blessed at Godspeed. We out. Leave your comments down below. Like the page, subscribe, and we be out.